I do believe this. We're going to have the American unipolar world where we're the single last superpower. That is definitely over. I think China is an emerging superpower by 2020. Economically and militarily, it'll be the dominant power in Asia. And I think an emerging superpower. Look, if they just...
But we're not dead by 2025,
then,
right?
The United States is not going to be... Oh, 2025, what concerns me is what's happening here at home, that we seem to be disintegrating as one nation, under God, indivisible. All those things we had, it seems to me we're losing. We are very much at war with each other. Mm-hmm. And it's over ideology, politics, religion, philosophy, everything. And the terms we're using on each other, I mean, I'm on cable as you are. Mm-hmm. I mean, every day somebody's calling somebody else a racist. We didn't use those kinds of terms on each other's, even during the civil rights era.
Mm-hmm. No, it's true. But your book has a chapter called The End of White America.
Right.
Which, it's a startling term, and I'm curious what you mean, because isn't the end of white America, as we see the rise of Hispanics, mm-hmm. A good thing? Proof that America is a melting pot, that anybody can succeed right. here, no matter the color of your skin right. or your right. religion or whatever.
Well, I'm a little concerned when people say, Pat, you know, the majority of people looking like you, that's coming to an end, Pat. So let me say this. What's wrong with this is the idea that when whites are a minority in this country in 2041 and Hispanics are 150 million, what is going to hold us together when we don't have a common religion, we don't have common beliefs about right and wrong and morality as we used to? We are at war over you know, whether or not equality means equality of rights or equality of rewards.
The American dream, the freedom, the belief, what caused the Arab Spring, that's what holds us together.
Do people, freedom and the idea of socialist equality and freedom are in mortal conflict. I was in China before you were born with Richard Nixon in 1972. The most equal society you've ever seen. Everybody had a blue Mao jacket on, and they were the poorest people you've ever seen. Now, tyranny, much of the tyranny has been lifted of Maoism, and it's an unequal society in China. Millionaires and billionaires, as Barack Obama would say, and poor people. But it is freer. Freedom and absolute equality are in conflict.
But equality of opportunity is what people want in this
Equality
country.
Of rights and equality of opportunity. You got it.
Before we go, who do you think is going to be the Republican ticket?
The ticket, I would say Romney Rubio, if I had to bet right now. But if I were Mitt Romney, I'd get into Iowa and shut this thing down, because if one person breaks out of there, he could have problems. They like Mitt, but I'm not sure they love him, Aaron.